This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Masks, one of the most used tools in video editing and visual effects. And you know, it's quite easy. You cut around the object that you want to mask and put a different background on it. I don't know. Yet, everyone hates masking because it never turns out the way that we want to, and it takes hours of work for just a few seconds of video. Now, don't get scared, because Jordi is here for you, and I've got 5 tips, or hacks, whatever you want to name it, that I wish that I knew before, because these tips are gonna make your masking life a whole much easier. Let's start with the first one. In Adobe After Effects, we've been masking an entire week, frame by frame, to cut out a subject. Cursing that you should have used a green screen. Well, it's too late for that. And then you decide to play back your video to see how it looks. 3 days of masking, and now comes the result. But something is wrong. Your mask doesn't follow your subject. You forgot to enable the animation for the mask pads. Yeah, I'm sorry, I don't have a solution for that. You're just simply screwed. But what if you did enable the animation? Well, then your mask follows the subject. But chances are that your mask is kind of dancing around as you move to different points. And here's a very quick solution to fix that. From the effects library, search for the key cleaner effect and drag that to your mask subject. From here, increase the alpha contrast, and this will smoothen out the hard edges and make their imperfections less visible. Now, with the edge radius, you can kind of define how far this smoothing has to go. Usually, you want to keep this at a low value. The next tip is something really stupid that I didn't knew about for a very long time, like way too long, until I saw it in one of the tutorials from Film Riot. Now, when you create a mask inside After Effects, you can feather it through the mask options, but sometimes you don't want it to feather everywhere. Well, if you click and hold on the mask tool, you'll find a feather tool. And this allows you to click and drag on your mask pad to feather it only on those points. Now you can shape the feather area perfectly the way that you want. Pretty cool, eh? It's so simple, but you just have to know that it's out there. Which is really the same as with our sponsor Storyblocks Video. You just gotta know it's out there. Because if you're looking for high quality stock clips or effects, transitions, flares, lower thirds, logo animations, slideshows, or anything else, then you need to know where to get that without breaking the bank. So that's where Storyblocks comes in, as there's only a single price per year, which allows you to download unlimited video assets. Now, we use it all the time, and I can highly recommend it to any video editor. So definitely make sure to check it out by clicking the first link in the description below. And now moving on to the masking trick number 3, automation. Now, in other words, tracking. And the cool thing is that this works in both After Effects and Premiere Pro. In After Effects, right-click on your mask layer and then choose Track Mask. You've got a few different methods in here, choose whatever you'd like and then hit play. Now, for very detailed masks, this doesn't really work, but if you're blurring out someone's face or a license plate, you know, this is perfect and will save you a lot of time. In Premiere Pro, you have the track options next to the mask pad. And like in After Effects, if you click on the tool button, you've got a few tracking methods. Tip 4. If you have a subject that needs to be masked out, don't create a mask for its entire body. After a couple of hours of animation, you'll always notice that there are a few points wrong. Adjusting them now is gonna take a lot of time, as you can't really delete keyframes or move the entire mask up, as that will mess up the other parts as well. So draw and animate a mask for individual spots. This also goes easier and faster, as you don't have to focus on the entire subject. Plus, you won't make mistakes that fast. Create a second mask for another part, which you can also animate, and a third and a fourth, as many as you like. You know, you can also create negative masks during this technique, cutting away specific parts, and usually I do this to clean up an already animated mask that has a few errors. Make sure that you set the mask to subtract to make it cut out a piece. This brings me to the last masking hack. This reminds me, here's a clip of Janik who's hacking a bank. It's hilarious. Anyways, the last tip is stupid again, but oh so life-saving if you just knew about it before. When you're animating a mask frame by frame, make sure to set your mask mode to none. And this allows you to better see where the edge is of your subject that you're masking out. And when you're done, you can set it back to add. In Premiere Pro, this works a little bit different. Here you want to disable the opacity property for the effect that you're masking on. When you're done, you can enable it back. Life could be so simple, right guys? Thank you so much for watching, thank you Storyblocks for your support, and as always, stay creative. What do you think of my background, guys? I know, you're probably thinking that I was in a forest somewhere right now, but it's not. I'm actually just sitting in the studio. I know. Mind blown there. Pretty cool, huh? Some branches, some leaves. Yeah.